the paper. This is the tools I'm going to talk about. And on the back, they write down, because we intellectually speed date. Who already does these, put their contact information on the back. So, and they're laminated, because no teacher will throw away anything once it's laminated.
That's so true.
So we give these to teachers, and they're busy people, I get it. So they put it in the desk, because it's laminated. When they get a chance, they pull it out and go, oh, it's that thing, yeah. Okay, and they're trying it again. Self-directed staff development, right? So this can be a small keyring you add to through the year. Simple. You can download it from my website on the front page in an Excel document, kevinhoneycutt.org. It's free. I'm not trying to make money here. I love this. I'm going to pass this around so you can see. We also added a Sharpie marker to it so people could write down information as they learned what each other's skills were. In the old days, you had a file cabinet. You locked it. You laminated your stuff, and you didn't share. We got to change that in the age of collaboration. We got to start sharing, helping each other help kids. This is a beginning of finding out what each other's expertise might be. Simple idea. This teacher's been teaching this lesson for 32 years. She calls it her cities project. Every kid gets a 2x2 piece of cardboard, and they make a business. At the end, they slide them together and make a city, and parents walk through like Godzilla and love it. Right? It's a cool thing. Popsicle sticks, Elmer's glue. Is it getting the junior high kids, the middle school kids, ready for the future? It's cute. Where did this boy stop caring about the white lines between the cars? Can you tell? Okay, this is one of the other kids. He made this school. This is a fifth grader. Here's his cardboard school. Here's his school using a free software called Google SketchUp. Works on the PC and the Mac, and it's free. Okay, grade school kids use it without reading the tutorial. Okay, so this is what he makes. This girl makes this teepee. I thought it was a teepee. I made the mistake of saying that. Nice teepee. It's not a teepee. What? Okay. Oh, sorry. This is what she meant it to look like. Okay. Well, I show this to the kids, and they start doing this stuff. Let me jump out of here real quick and back in again. And the kids text messaged me and said, Kevin, we tried to do this, and our teacher wouldn't take it for a grade. She said it wasn't real. She didn't think it was real until it was made of paper. Right? Right? Free. Now, here's something that happened. The place where I work was hiring an architect to make a version of our place in styrofoam so we could plan on building on. He wanted $10,000 to make a styrofoam model. So we hired a fifth grader using Google SketchUp. For $8 an hour, he was done in 16 hours. This kid was cool. He came to our office and said, where's the floor plan? We didn't even know. We had to go find the floor plan. He laid it all out. He designed our place 3D interactive in 16 hours. My boss should have paid him better than that.